So guys, so obviously Doris, you know me, but Angela, so I'm Nate Marshall. I'm with Private Money Authority. Don't worry, this is like has to do with that's Keith. They know it attempts. I'm actually getting a couple of implants at the in the fall from the Army for an injury I had in the Army. So this is the t-shirt my dentist gave me. It's like to promote that. So I'm doing this as a scope of work event just quickly, and I'm going to put it out there on our YouTube and some other into some of our groups. Basically, because there's a lot of issues out there with scope of work, just like with the private money. Remember, I'm also going to be doing a private money discussion on Wednesday night at 5 p.m. Denver time, which will be which will be great. But scope of work, a lot of people have problems with it, and they don't have good forms to use. They don't have good documents. They don't have a strong agreement with the contractor. And a lot of times that's where people can get hurt, not only in doing the estimates, estimating what your rehab costs are going to be, your construction costs are going to be for your loan, whether you're going through a hard money lender or you're going through, investors or using your own money. You can actually set yourself up to fail if you don't get the right, do the right scope of work. And we're not going to go into comps and stuff because that's a different story. Tonight, I'm really going to focus on the doing the scope of work and the processes for working with contractors. And then I'm going to give you guys a few links that are going to be, you can use them. One of them is an interesting link, and I'll tell you a little bit about it. I'm going to turn the camera off because I don't want it to get up too much. I'll kind of just tell everybody publicly that I've got a friend of mine who has a tech company that does a lot of data, and they have the ability to do, they can actually do estimates for in almost any market. They can actually print takeoffs, which are like, for contractors and construction companies, the takeoffs for all their measurements. So they can actually do a deep dive into a lot of the construction costs. So I'm meeting with him next week. I used to work for him 6-7 years ago. I worked for him about a year in the construction business, and he had a construction business that did about 20,000 roofs, and they did a storm restoration, and they do a lot of homes in Aspen and Vail, and big affluent multi, McMansions. And so he built a tech company because he needed data to do a better job. He did 20,000 roofs in like 8 years, which is unheard of. I mean, he just very quality, high quality roofing and storm restoration company. And he does a lot more high end, like I said, a lot more high end, but his tech company has the ability to do takeoffs, measurements from aerial. And I think Joyce, you've heard me talk about it a few times probably, but he can do insulation. I mean, literally he can tell you how much insulation you need in that house. Obviously on insulation, you got to be able to still go in the attic and measure the insulation in there because they can't see that, obviously. If they could see that, then we got other problems. But they can actually do a measurement of the roof, and they can actually kind of determine how much insulation you should have. So when you go in there at the Owen Corning, they have the little paper rulers that are like 3 feet. They're like paper. You can get them at Home Depot and stuff in the insulation aisle. And you can measure. You put 10 or 12 of them up there in your attic, and you can measure how much insulation you have, and it tells you how much to add. They can actually do a calculation, and then they know how much to blow in. And they also can do concrete, they can do painting, they can do gutters, they can do siding. They can actually do siding versus paint. So if your house is, if you're going to replace siding, but you've also got painted surfaces, they can break all that down. They can do the roof. They can do a whole lot of stuff. And he's coming out with an incredible product, adding to his company. So I'm going to give you guys the link. And then obviously once I get a deal working with him a little bit more on it, I'm going to hook him up with Privy, which I've talked about before. So Angel, if you're not familiar with Privy, it's getprivynow.com. Privy is a great resource. Benson Juarez, who's actually a friend of mine in Denver, where I live in the Denver area. Privy is a great resource for real estate investors. And you can literally buy properties right off of Privy. And you don't need to do very much. I mean, there is on-market and off-market. So just for grins, because I know Doris, you hear us talk about, we talk about Privy all the time on our meetings. But so just Angela, for your record, and anybody else that's watching that's not on this right now. So this is the website for getprivynow.com. And then I'm going to have give me a second. I've got to actually make sure I get the link right. He's got a couple, you can actually go to like My Roof Scope, and there's some other, he has like 9 or 10 different links. I just want to send you the right link. That's like the master link. So I just to make sure it's still. So give me a second so I can look that up on my phone. I can make sure I get the exact one. Okay, so it's myscopetech.com. And like I said, he's very interested. I'm going to have a meeting with him next week after Memorial Day when he gets back into town after. So those are two resources. Privy is obviously a paid program. I think Benson was doing it for $97 a month or just under $1,000 a year. You get a discount of them if you do the annual plan. So those are two things. But myscopetech, and you can actually get an account there. And here's where myscopetech is awesome, because very few, I'm going to say, hardly anybody knows about it unless they're also doing storm or some kind of roofing work and they're in real estate investing, and they may have heard of it. Nobody's doing it. So if you decide, so anybody that's listening, there's a, if you go to scope, you know, if you go to that, you might be worth getting a really good tool for your real estate business that none of your competitors know about. So it's phenomenal. So I like to pass these tips on, these links on, and I'm always about trying to do that. Another good one, and I'm going to talk about it real quick, and then I'm going to share the contractor agreement and stuff. We're going to try to get this done in about 45 minutes, because I know everybody, you know, people who watch on, who'll be watching on YouTube don't usually watch very long. You know, I actually see what my stats are, my watch hours. So Company Cam, and Doris, you've heard of me talk about Company Cam. Company Cam is a great program, and you can go on there and you can get a free version, you can get a paid version. You really don't need more than the free version until you really scale up. I mean, if you start doing massive dozens, if not hundreds of flips or properties, you can get by on the free version. There's two things. One thing is, Company Cam is used a lot of times in restoration work. We used it when I worked for my friend, for his company that has Scope Tech. He actually introduced me to Company Cam. I've used it in both in my construction company that I, when I transitioned in 2018. In 2017, I became a private money broker. In 2018, I switched completely out of roofing. At that time, I was doing both. And that first year, I was a private money broker. And then I basically, I use Company Cam a lot in the construction, but I started using it in when I brokered, introducing it, because in a construction setting, you can actually, you know, guys who are doing work and they have to go get, you have to get work done. There's two ways that people get, you know, paid in during insurance claims as a contractor. They get the, what they call the ACV, the actual cash value. That's what the insurance company gives you, that first check, and maybe it's 60% of the job. And then to get the last 40%, you have to complete certain work to get that second and maybe that third check from the insurance company. So a lot of times Company Cam would help us in basically being able to take a ton of pictures. We would take them, our crews would take them. Sometimes we had to replace the decking in the roofs because, you know, the code back, they used to call it, it was like really space decking. And space decking, there was like a little bit of that gaps. They were like 1x4s, you know, that went, it wasn't like the old plywood. So there were gaps. So the new construction, they basically, the code doesn't let you use those. You have to use plywood, you know, OSB. And so you have to have a nailable surface. So we would sometimes get that supplemented. We wouldn't get it in the first check, and they would get it in the second check after we did it, because by code, it's, you have to make it a nailable surface. And that's, you know, how much the code changes. So long story short, when we get to a real estate investor where we were having to show it for to insurance companies to get paid on our work, we're sometimes showing it to a client. Now think about this on two levels. One, if you're a private money lender, you're a lender or you're a lending company, you could require, you're going to have draws and you're going to be doing draws. And I'm going to show you guys a couple of different draw schedules. You can use whichever one you want. You can make them uniform fillable. They're editable. You can put your own logo on them, but you could actually, they could actually make it like, you know, instead of having an inspector come out, which you pay for, you can upload those pictures. So now if you got this draw, this is the week you're doing the kitchen cabinets. You got to have the counter in, you got to have the, you know, get ready for the appliances. For that draw, you need to take pictures of all that work being complete. So now you got your backsplash in, you got your tile work, you got your cabinets, you got your countertop, you got your flooring, you got your appliances, kitchen's done, you're getting paid in that draw. So as a real estate investor, you can actually do that and require your contractor to put those pictures in there. And you can upload it in real time. You can also do video. Plus you can build a file. You can build a documents folder for your pictures for that house or that whatever you're doing. So it's a great accountability system. And like I said, you can use it free. You're not going to need the paid version for quite a while. The paid version has some features, but and it's not even that. I think it was like $100 a year. It was like ridiculous. There's a couple of different packages, but you only really need the free version of Company Cam. So I'm kind of talking, you know, so that's a good, that's what I'm suggesting too. One more that I'm just going to throw out there right now before I do the documents is HomeWise. HomeWise is, and you kind of have to be, you know, it's not 100% guaranteed. And again, I have to make sure I've got the right link. I also make sure I get the right link. HomeWise will actually do a pretty good job because you can go in and you can put the market. So you can put like what zip code. I'm in 80439. So I can put in 80439 and it'll come up with, and you can do a lot of different, you know, it's not, you can't really write a lot of specs, but it does have a lot of stuff written in there. So if you're telling, hey, I'm gonna do the backsplash and I'm gonna do this and it's gonna be this dimensions, you can come back with what that zip code generally has a range of low, you know, median and high. I recommend most of the people just go high in your estimating. So homewise.com can do a lot for doing estimates. The other way you guys can do it too is you can actually, you know, develop relationships with the pro desks at Home Depot, Lowe's, Menards, because they have great resources at the pro desk. A lot of guys. Now, those companies have gotten away just because of how big they are. When they first started, maybe in the 80s, into the mid 90s, even maybe to the 2000s, you used to be able to find like guys that were retired electricians and plumbers. They could guide you through some of the stuff. But developing relationships with some people and Lowe's and the pro desk, opening a separate LLC as a construction company or rehab company, you're not doing the work, but you could start actually getting a lot of benefits from that, which can actually help you save a lot of time and money because you can become a GC and you can actually pay yourself on that. So those are four links I provide to everybody because they help people get. Privy Now is a great system. You can basically, once you connect it with some of the systems that we have in our associates program, which is what Doris is in, we give a lot of resources, our 20,000 lender and investor contacts, all, I mean, like hundreds of documents and things like that. Plus, you know, we got a 16-week program coming up starting in June for just $399. You know, it's a great program to learn the private money business, learn how to use analyzers, learn how to use a lot more system. We go through a lot of discussions every Monday night, every Wednesday night, starting June 5th, all the way through Thanksgiving. We'll be doing discussions about real estate investing, how to get private money, how to do loans, how to lend money, how to borrow money, and all the technical stuff, all the analyzers. We give you analyzers in a CRM and all that stuff. So those are the four links. So, and everybody's watching, and Angela, just, you know, I, George can attest to this. It's always sometimes a challenge for me to bring up to share screen. That's what Doris laughs. You know, every week I go through the same thing. It sucks. I kind of, for some reason, I have a glitch in my system and it doesn't let me do it on the first. So what I'm going to show you guys real quick is a contractor agreement. And I know it's going to take me, I usually have to get in and out one. You know, so Doris, let me know when you see it because you know how this works.
Okay.
So. And you guys can, okay, so Angela, and I'll be emailing this with everybody that signed up. So Doris, you can access it in files. It's actually, okay. It's uploaded in the associates group. So this is a really strong contractor agreement. I'm not going to go too much in detail. You can just, you'll get it tomorrow in the email that I send, and I'll send these documents, the same documents I'm sending now. So you guys can, you know, and then you can actually just copy it out. And then, you know, you can do copy and paste. However you want to do it, you can just copy and paste it and transfer it over in Word and make your own. And then you can put your logo and stuff on it. This isn't PDF version. I just did it so it just saves a little bit of, makes it a little easier to save it for me in PDF. But this is strong because this is contractor because you're doing your fee and draw schedule. And so first thing you're going to really do is your fee and draw schedule, which says per scope of work is outlined in Addendum A of this agreement. Contractor will charge a fee of, so you are basically the client and they're the contractor. Now, if somebody's here as a contractor and they want to get this, they can, it's the same form. So this is a single family home. Obviously, if you guys are going to be doing like multifamily or something, like I said, you can just do copy and paste. You can actually, just, you know, if you want to take the time and type it out, you got an example. Either way, it's easy to do it. So most of my, a lot of my forms, you guys will see that I'm showing you in a minute are form fillable. This one, unfortunately, is not. So, but I want to give you at least a form where you can find, you know, you can use copy and paste or other means to actually use, put this to use. So, you know, you've got all the draw requests, and we're going to show you the scope of work schedule and draw requests on other forms. So, but this is actually the contract. And a lot of people don't have a really good contractor agreement. This one is strong. So when you got draws, you know, how many draws per week, you know, how many you got, you know, if you got six draws or eight draws, I normally say if you're going to be doing a project for 90 days, you probably need at least four draws, but as many as 6 weeks, they have a weekly drawing. And what I'll talk about, like in the scope of work forms that I show you in a minute, is that you always want to have a contingency, and then you always want to have a holdback. A holdback is where you're holding back like 10% or 15% of the total job from the contractor until it has passed all inspections. That is your protect. That is protecting you. Now, where you're going to have this is that you're going to want to have this is, becomes a three-way deal, because if you have a lender, your lender will love this because you've got a strong contractor agreement and you've got scope of work and draw schedules. So your lender, if your lender isn't providing those to you, then you can use your own. So you want to talk to a lender. That usually works out if you get an individual lender, not one of the, you know, we got 20,000 lenders and investors contacts. If you're not using somebody that has their own, you can ask them if you can use all this. And it gives you an advantage because you don't have to worry about, and especially if you work with us in the associate program or our real estate investors library, you get access to all this. So I don't want stuff stripping up on my computer. Bonuses and penalties. So there's a lot of bonuses. You know, I always try to do a few bonuses. I recommend it. It just helps contractors feel good. Like, hey, they're getting work done. They're getting it done early. You know, if you're able to put it on the market before it's done, because it's done enough that you can actually show it and start getting pictures for, you know, your realtor can start getting pictures and stuff. You guys can, it helps you a lot. Sell it, flip, get it sold, or get on the market for rental. And there's also penalties, which is good. So put the penalty in there and the bonus in there. And then, you know, your contractor has it in black and white. You know, here's a penalty if you don't get this done on time, this draw this week. You don't get, if you do, if you get this done, it passes the first time, there's no reinspections, then you can get a bonus. You got your plans, specifications, selections, and, you know, allowances. Client to select finished materials. Just make sure that you always have it, you know, and Joyce, you've heard me last week talk about government business days. You guys, everything you want to do is client select. And you want to have as much, you know, some contractors are going to have good relationships with their suppliers. I hear a lot of people in the real estate groups complain, oh no, I want to buy, you know, I don't want my contractor to buy it. It's like, you know, a contractor, most cases, is going to have a better deal than you are because they're doing in volume. If you hire the right contractor, even if they're going to Home Depot or Lowe's, when I had my construction business, I had $20,000 of credit in Home Depot. And I tell you what, when I go in there and I spend $8,000 at Home Depot on my card, I have like 60 days sim as cash as my contractor card, which is great because then, you know, I was doing insurance work. We weren't doing it like it was client money. I did some jobs with client money, but most of them was insurance companies, and I would have to wait till the work was done to get paid by the insurance company. And usually take 30 to 45 days. So having 60 days and then eventually 90 days helped me. But also, if you have your own LLC separate from your real estate investing company and you are a GC and you have, you know, you have a bunch of these, you know, if you have a bunch of these systems and you have all these cards, I paid 17 cents one time to fill my tank of gas and I had a truck because I had fuel rewards. So that was great. So that's why I always recommend that, because if you guys have, hey, Matt, welcome. I'm just going over the first document. I went over some links earlier. I'll make sure you get them. And I'm also going to send this out to you guys as well in the morning when I process it. I'll send you out the videos. So you only missed like 10 minutes, just some links and stuff. So I'm going over my contractor agreement, and you guys can feel free to use this. You'll actually get a copy of this. Unfortunately, this is one you can't copy. You know, you can copy and paste and you can write it out, but it's a strong contractor agreement with your, you know, between you as an investor or you're hiring a contractor. And I'll talk about, I'll go back and rehash at the end the links as well, just kind of giving a few, because there's every link I gave you is something that nobody real estate is using any of the four resources that I gave everybody. So you get an advantage. It gives you something to strive for. You get into minor alterations. We talk about alterations can be sometimes field alterations, a judgment call. You know, contractor, you know, if the contractor's out there in the field and you're distant, you may have to give them some allowances If they have to make something, some kind of change code, or, you know, if you get a code guy out there and he tells them to do something, they have to do it, then they may have to do something on the spot. You know, you need to have some kind of, you know, agreement. You can actually make an addendum to this to, you know, you make the addendum and you put a, you know, title addendum and put the item 5 minor alterations. Then you can put, you know, what your agreement is, you know, that it has to be, you know, cleared by you, or you can modify this by saying, hey, you know, you need to call me if it's over this much. You've got this much leeway. If it's going to cost $500 or less to do this, then, you know, you can go ahead and do it on your, you know, if you get a direction of what they call the AHJ, which is the authority having jurisdiction, the buildings inspector, the fire department. You know, I used to be a fire marshal and a fire chief, and I had a jurisdiction. I could make people do stuff for that were fire code related. So you're going to have minor alterations and change orders. Get into 6, we got change orders. Obviously, you can. I do have a change order form. It's not that strong. I've used it a few times. I haven't used it since I have my roofing company, so it's been 5 or 6 years. So I want to update it a little bit. But changes, you should have a change order form that's separate, and that way, if your contractor needs to make a change, or if you've got to make a change, you got to realize you're probably going to pay for it. If the contractor needs to make a change for some reason, then they need to justify the expense. And why, like I said, if it comes down to a code issue, then, you know, sometimes who knows, a code issue could actually be pretty pricey. I mean, you guys have all seen I tell people don't watch the flipping shows once you get into this business, because then you kind of realize that it's kind of entertainment value only. There's a lot of stuff that they do that I think, you know, almost reality shows, the producers are trying to create some, obviously some ratings and stuff like that. But just to get back to this, you know, changes. You also want to talk about contractors. Here's a key point, guys, about limited warranties. Try to get a contractor that'll give you a limited warranty that you can pass on to your buyer. That way it says, you know, for the next 12 months, if there's a problem with electrical or plumbing for the next 12 months or something, and you could even buy warranty. You guys have heard about the warranty companies out there. There's a few out there. I don't recommend a single one because they're not in every city. And so I don't want to give you guys, I'd have to give you like 100 of them. There's a few that are really good. If you know that one that's good, use it. But I also like going back to Home Depot and Lowe's and stuff. I like to have them do the work, because, you know, if you have a problem with Home Depot or Lowe's, they're going to fix it. And they're not going to, you know, their contractors are screened and their background checked and all that stuff. And so, you know, if there's a problem, they're supposed to fix it. Now, of course, you'll hear the horror stories. But, you know, if you're looking at doing stuff like carpet and tile and that kind of stuff, and it's like you're just doing a regular flip, or maybe you're doing a rental. If you're doing a rental property on a single family, you can probably get away with just doing a really good, you know, a good upgrade, but not a great, you know, you're not going, you know, I always tell people go one level above where the neighborhood is. You know, if they got a little bit of, you know, a little bit of fake granite, maybe get a little bit of real granite or something, you know, you can go to, there's some places, I know there's a guy in Denver who does like granite, and he basically is awesome. He's recommended by all the, you know, all the home, you know, advisor type people in Denver, which we have two of them. We have this guy, Tom Martino in Denver, who's been on the radio 40 years. He's recovered like hundreds of millions of dollars from scams and things like that for people. And then Dave Logan has Team Dave Logan in Denver, and he's like Dave Ramsey, but Dave Logan is a huge star. He played for the Broncos and the Cleveland Browns. He was drafted in three sports, drafted in three sports. He was drafted in football, baseball, and basketball. And he is actually the radio host for the Denver Broncos on there. You know, so he's worked with them ever since he retired as a player. He has a radio show. I mean, you guys can Google Dave Logan. He's a high school football coach. He's won 10 state championships in 5 schools. So the guy knows his football, but he has a huge network, and people like plumbers and mechanics and all kinds of people advertise. It's not cheap, and he get, you know, he get, sort of Tom Martino, they kind of compete against each other. They both have radio shows. Dave Logan's more of a sports, you know, his radio show is sports, and Tom's just basically, you know, you got ripped off by a car dealer, you know, but Tom's a legend. You know, he's a great guy. I've actually called in a few times to his show, and so you want to kind of maybe look for those kind of guys in your area, wherever you live at. If you're going to virtual, you know, look and see if there's radio people and there's people that have those kind of programs. Because if you go to somewhere like Las Vegas and you got somebody like a Dave Logan or a Tom Martino that has like a network of plumbers and mechanics, use those guys, because those guys are, it costs a pretty penny to get in those networks. and they have to pass even more stringent back. I mean, it's hard to get into either of those companies without having a thorough track record. And nobody that, so you want to look in your areas and see. So, I mean, just go to like 850K OA or 630K HAL. I'll give you guys those two websites. You guys can go and you can look at those guys and just push, get, you know, chips and giggles, you know, go in there and see, and then look in your areas, radio, TV stations, and see if you guys can find somebody, because it's a great resource for you guys to find resources, to find contractors, to find plumbers, to find HVAC guys. It's some great stuff. Those are the radio stations, the name of the guys. And, you know, I know that they probably don't, you know, you're not going to find them if you're in Las Vegas or New York, but you might have guys out there that do the same thing. So those are a couple of the resources I provide for you guys. Construction compliance, obviously standards, federal, state, local governments, those ordinances, regulations. Make sure they're licensed, guys. There's another key from my past is when I was in the roofing business. You want to ask for their certificate of insurance, get their general liability and workers' comp. In some states, if it's just a single person, ask them to give you a statement that they are a single person. If it's just them, they don't need workers' comp. Then some states like Colorado has Pinnacle. Pinnacle is the state agency that oversees workers' comp, and they can get you can actually download it on it for free, and they do a Pinnacle waiver. They have to fill it out and get it notarized that I am a sole worker. So you want to look in your state or your area and see if, you know, if you hire just a one-man show, still get them to sign some kind of waiver that, hey, I am by myself. I am a one-man show. I don't have any employees. If there are companies out there, like when I was in the roofing business, we had a lot of guys that were 1099s. Most of the companies that I worked for still had, you know, they still had to get workers' comp. So make sure when you get the certificate, your name is additional insured, and the property that they're working on is insured, additional insured. And then you also want to call the insurance carrier. Don't call the agent, because I had it happen one time where somebody put an agent down, and luckily we called and the agent was just a friend of theirs. They basically got a payment plan, paid the down payment, didn't pay any other payments. So they had their certificate. That's how you get $10,000. And workers' comp premium, and you only pay $1,000, and basically if nobody checks, and they get a, you know, they don't have to do it till next year, and they can just change insurance companies to get any policy that, you know, after 2 or 3 years go by, it catches up to them. But, you know, I dealt with a lot with storms in Colorado, and those are a lot of fly-by-nights. Colorado's the number two after Texas, and we get a big hailstorm, and it's like everybody and their brother opens a construction company because the money's flowing. The insurance companies, they're writing checks within days. And I made good money to that. I made a couple $100,000 in 1 year. I did that for 6 years and made some good money. But obviously, I just didn't want to depend my whole life and income on nature. Because some years we were dry. And it's like we're always trying to get, it's always great in May to October. But those winter months when the work starts drying up, the good thing is in the winter, all the guys are leaving to go back to Texas because they don't want to be here in the snow. And everybody has a misconception of Colorado. So you also want to make sure you have completion timing. You know, when's the certificate of occupancy, contractor will give client 30 days notice prior to estimated closing. So if you're doing a long-term thing, you want, hey, this is 30 days notice. We're going to be done on November 30th. Go back to the line about penalties and bonuses. Guess what? If it's not done on November 30th, every day is going to be a penalty. If it's done on November 25th, I'm going to give you a bonus. If you're done 5 days early, obviously November 25th would run into probably Thanksgiving. So good luck with that. But just giving you guys kind of a you know, something. Make sure this gets back to the insurance. You know, make sure it's retail value of the. I'm just pointing out some things. You guys will get this downloaded so you can go through it in your own. Make sure that safety, all the, you know, hazardous materials, if they're using paint and all kinds of hazmat stuff, make sure it's secured. You know, if there's an inside space, make sure it's ventilated. Have them require it. Have them get a safety kit. Make sure they have a first aid kit. And if they do have workers, I mean, you guys could go get your own forms. There's actually a box they sell on Home Depot and Staples, I think, even has one. It's like a box, and it sets it up, and they got the things, and you can put the permits on it and all that. You know, and they can secure it. You can leave it. You can actually put it outside. So the permits slide in and the inspector can pull the permit card out, but then slide it back in and then it's protected from the elements. And you could actually get something like that. And then it has the first aid kit and the, I think it's like $100. So if you're doing like, if you're really making this your business, you know, if your contractors don't have them, get your own. Just make yourself look that much better. Hey, you know, if a buyer comes by and you're still under construction and they see, hey, this guy's got his stuff together, you know, and he's got, he's, you know, that helps sometimes because they're showing, hey, this guy's taking, you know, he's looking at some quality. Make sure they get the liability insurance and then, you know, contractors, you know, all their rights and, you know, the contractor rights, walkthrough inspections. Contractor will schedule a walkthrough inspection with the client to determine final punch list. That's where you're going to want to hold. Here's where we talk about withholding or hold back. Final payment in the amount of shall be withheld until such punch list is completed in full. I would say 10%, 15%. There's also dispute resolution. Keep in mind, research this with your state because some states are different. And you can always, like I said, you can copy and paste this. You can type it out yourself and you can put in there what it is, you know, that's in there. Authority of signatory, your successors and assigners. If you got partners, if something, God forbid, happens to anybody, put in who can act on your behalf with a power of attorney or something like that. Complete it, you know, no oral agreements, headings, you know, getting the builder's fee, supervision, other costs. And then you got to, you know, then to measure actually scope of work. So guys, this is actually a strong, and I'll give everybody, I'm going to send everybody who signed up, including a few people, because, you know, things change. I'm going to be doing something like this every Monday. I'm going to be doing a Wednesday. I'm going to be doing private money, talking about real estate investors and lenders. For those who are on here, I mean, Taurus is in our program. You guys are interested, the other two of you and everybody else that's listening. We do have a private money program. We've been going since January. We're starting a new one starting June 5th and June 7th. It's only $399 for 16 weeks. We give you dozens and dozens and dozens of documents, resources. We have 20,000 contacts, investors and lenders. We give you a searchable database and we'll have the 2.0. We have the 1.0 right now that has about 1,000. We have the 2.0 will be done in the next couple of weeks. I've got it in revision. You'll be able to have 10,000 contacts and I'm working on another 12,000 contacts. So think about being able to search and find lenders and investors, you know, 20,000 of them, and be able to go and find, you know, a lot of resources for people. So that's kind of our contractor agreement. Like I said, you guys will get emailed tomorrow. And then I'm gonna go through a couple other forms real quick tonight, run this for you. And if you're interested in more talking about the other, our associate program or our investor library, we have a resource library, reach out to me afterwards or the next day or two. Cause like I said, we have about 6 openings and it starts next, it'll start in 2 weeks. We're not gonna do anything next week for the Memorial Day, but the following week, June 5th, and June 7th, and it'll be Wednesday nights will be the new program. The existing guys, people in programs will be doing Mondays still. And then you guys can do both, but they're going to be doing like a deal desk. Like, and we have some in-house lenders, some guys that are doing, a lot of guys that are doing, they can lend money on EMD and transaction funding. So we have our own group of like, you guys heard of the Gators. We have our own small group of about 10 people that can lend money in our group and they'll lend money to you guys. So if you get into our associate program, you got people you can pretty much work with. Doris can attest to that. So, mm-hmm. Yeah. So give me a second. Like I said, for those guys who have just getting used to me, I always kind of struggle with the share screen. So let's see. Okay. So this is a good draft schedule and I'm going to give you guys like 3 different versions of it because some of these are pretty expensive. You can go down and this talks about contingency and inspections. So I'm just going to go down. I'm going to go back up and show the top, but getting back to what I talk about contingency and then what I'm getting back to inspections. So you have inspection fees, you know, $190 is 2. If you can go 2 draws, 4 draws. I mean, you can start adding out to your draws what you're getting charged for inspections. But if you want to, you can go ahead and change this and you can put hold back and then you could even put here's the holdback and here's contingency. This is pretty much for you, but you want to give a copy of this to your contractor. So now I'll go back to the top. Like I said, I've got a couple of different versions I'm going to show you. Obviously, you're working on, you know, it starts with permits and inspections. Most forms don't have asbestos, soil, termite, mold, you know, dumpster eviction. You know, you guys have an eviction process. If you're buying a house and, you know, it's wrecked, you guys hear all the horror stories. You need the dumpster. You need the power wash, the porta potties, the trash, demolition, excavation, shoring, breaching. Hopefully there's things in here you never need, but it gives you a good idea of what's in different stages. Like, this is all going to be stage one is all you're going to, so you're going to put your cost, what you're going to estimate cost and what the draw is for that and what draw to and amount. And remember, you can make your additional sales. You can go all the way to Z. So you can just add those yourselves. It's pretty easy, but this is just one of them, and you guys will have this. And so you can download it. It's in Excel. You can, use it per job. So if you're doing, five or six of these, just save it five or six times and put it under different numbers. You know, this one gets down into some pretty, it gets down into different, obviously in kitchen cabinets, you got different areas. You got your kitchen sink, your cabinets, countertops, appliances, your labor, things like that. You can separate, tile, prep, finish. I mean, you start getting to some things will cover some areas. Stage four is going to be a lot of, hopefully you got your tile and all that stuff down before you do your, you got your flooring before you do your cabinets. You got your cleanup of the labor, getting your curbs, your driveway, septic, sewer, fire alarm, sprinklers. One more key point, guys, ADT, you guys see Ring and you guys see all the Simple Safe and whatever it's called. ADT is a really good, they've been around over 100 years. Like I said, if you guys missed it earlier, I was a fire chief and fire marshal. I used to be on a board for the 911 center. In my jurisdiction. And so ADT is probably the best relationship with fire, police, and medical for getting resources out. They train their dispatchers and their people to the same standards that a lot of the 911 centers do. So it's a great service if you're looking to do something to protect a home while it's under renovation, you acquire it, to get an ADT guy out there. Because you can get the little, if you're going to do a new door, obviously you want to have the new door on first, but they can put you can get the lock, guys. You can get the lock with the app that you can change the code. It's great if you're doing Airbnb as well. But then you can get the camera in the door and you can get the window. They give you usually like 3 to 5 different items. You can get the garage door. You can get a fire alarm, but CO2, obviously you want to have integrated one, but you can get an ADT guy out there. Just the other beauty of it is you prepay like a year. You might be able to get a program where you can just transfer it to your buyer. Or, if you've got a renter, using that, hey, I've got protection for you guys. So ADT is one of the best out there you can get, and it helps you. You might actually be able to add that cost and even add a little bit of percentage profit-wise in your sale, or add a little bit to rent for providing a security system. So fire alarms and sprinklers and all that stuff. And if anybody ever has any things where you're going to talk about a fire marshal, fire chief about your property, you can reach out to me because I used to do that. I used to be the county fire chief in Las Cruces, New Mexico. So I had over, 300 firefighters. I worked for Steamboat Springs, Colorado, Foothills Fire in Colorado, and a couple other. I worked for Balad Air Base in Iraq. I was the fire chief there, which is interesting when you're trying to put fires out and you're getting shot at and you're getting, mortared by terrorists. So if you guys ever have any questions about fire protection for your properties, so this is just one form, and you guys will get this. Like I said, then you guys can actually go through and pick a couple things out if you want to use it. Another one's called project. Obviously, you've got project costs. Like I said, and it gets into just a few. It'll take me a second to get back to it. I apologize for this. It's just what you like. There's nothing really different about it. Some of them are just set up different. So you guys will get all these, and then you can just, use whichever one you want. And if you like one better, how it's set up or how you can modify it to make it your own. I'm not really going to go too much into this one, but you can, there's a little bit more descriptions. This one does offer you a point where you can put a little bit more descriptions than the other one does. And so you can get into some others, which is great. The other one doesn't have too many others where you can add things, but it gets into a lot of saying, here's some more others, and you get into construction contingency. You get into, you can take out the draw fees, whatever. What I was talking about company cam before, like I said, that's a good way if you're a private money lender, or if you can have a relationship with your lender and even your contractor and use company cam, you might be able to eliminate draw fees. Draw fees are generally where your lender is sending people out to inspect your properties before they pay the draws. So sometimes if you can find a way to eliminate those, it saves, it saves you a couple $100. It might save $1,000, $2,000 on the whole project, but it's still, we're in a business where you're trying to make money and you're trying to, That little bit of money you could save doing that, if you could do virtual with company cam, you could actually probably add marble or granite or something in your kitchen, or you could add some kind of little upgrade to, like I said, be that one level above the comps. So if the comps are showing, hey, I've got a simulated something, or it's, you know, you go to Home Depot, they got the new aisle that's like laminated, but it looks real. But what if you go to the actual laminated, and you can do that because you just saved $1,000 on your draw fees by using a company cam for free. And you could take that $1,000 difference and you could actually get, you know, a little bit better flooring, maybe a little bit better features, maybe go to stainless steel appliances, you know, just a little bit of tips here and there where you could actually save some money legitimately without sacrificing the quality and what the, you know, the comparative values are. So there's just one more form. And then I'm going to show you guys one more thing. This is more or less for you guys. And we had, like I said, we had 8 people, and I'll make sure that everybody else gets it. A couple of people notified me before that they weren't going to be able to make it. I'm going to show you guys real quick our 1.0, our lender database. And if you guys are interested in just getting the lender database, I will make it, you know, I'm going to go back to it. I keep bouncing around. Oh, it's coming up. Maybe I saved it somehow. I think I may have saved it wrong. So I'll just try to see if I can go find it real quick. If not, I'll make sure you guys get it emailed to you, or at least show you guys a copy of it. I don't know why I had a... Yeah, for some reason, let me go see if I can actually see if I can find it. Guys, they're seeing probably for the first time all the stuff I have. Tonight we'll be doing analyzers in our associate program. So let me make sure I can get it. Nope, that's how I save the refs. I have like some like screenshots and stuff I show people. I'm trying to give me 1 second so I can pull this up. Okay. Give me 1 second so I'll be able to get this for you guys. And then I'll have to, like I said, sometimes I have to do it like twice. I need this, my computer's really weird. Let me show you guys this. So, and I'll tell you guys what's actually in the revision that's coming out. This is my database. And we have lender lists, 3 lender lists right now in this one. The revision is actually adding 7 more. And let me... The revision is adding 7 more. So there'll be 7 more tabs here. That'll come up. We're calling this the 1.0. The 2.0 is basically adding about 10,000 more contacts, 7 databases. One is single family offices. We got multiple family offices, hedge funds, endowment funds, pension funds. Then probably at the end of the summer, I'm working on finishing it right now with 12,000. And we've got 7 databases of just known real estate investors in different categories. Known investors for flips, known investors for single family rentals, short-term rentals. So it covers everything. If you want to do short-term rentals, multifamily investors, things like that. So imagine having 20,000 contacts. At that point, there'll be 20 tabs. So if you click on the pivot lender list and you go over to the fields, you can actually pull up, obviously there's the same data for each of these lists. And eventually, like I said, there'll be 20. I'll also show you a few things that I'm going to fix by the 3.0. I won't fix, I'm done by the 2.0, but you can actually click on the lenders, which is great. And then you've got, you know, your lender list, and that becomes alphabetical A to Z. Keep in mind, there are a few duplicates in here between lender list 1 and lender list 2. There's a few in here that are on both. And then there are some that aren't in either. Some may not be in business yet. We have over 1,300 of them. There's about 800 in this list because I've got some out in vetting. I'm going to pull about a third of them out every 3 to 4 months, and I hire a VA to basically contact them. And I'm actually getting better at this. I've got a friend of mine who does data. I told you know everybody about it before. I'm going to get him to actually, he has the ability because he scrapes data. He provides data to the roofing companies, and we're talking to them about incorporating with the real estate investors because it's the same data sets where you can actually get takeoff scenario measurements and all this stuff. And we're actually going to be able to vet this using AI now instead of having to use human, which is going to be great. So in some cases, when you go to find a lender, if you guys find somebody, if you guys want the list and you guys get it, you know, you get the databases and all that stuff. If you find somebody who's not responsive, then give back to me and I'll have it vetted. And if they're unresponsive to me, I'll remove them. Some of them are actually not lending right now. Civic was rumored to have gone out of business. They are in business. They just terminated their CEO and their CFO, their board. So they will be lending again probably by the end of the summer. But you can go over here, you can pull up their contact data. So you can go in these lists. Now you can go and you start getting more of a, you start opening the field. This is one glitch in it that I do have to apologize for, and I'm going to try to fix it by the 3.0. When I have a VA do it, obviously there is, this is like one line, the zip code all the way to the number. So there are websites, guys, but you know, you do have to, so I'm not making it, it's not 100% perfect. You will have to do a little bit of work on it, but you can just like go, I mean, at least it's there. The number one thing, if you've got a lot, you're going to have, by the time the 3.0 comes out, you're going to have over 20,000 contacts. And you can also come over here now, you can start breaking it down even more, preferred lending type, funding type. So you can start pulling up all you go into hard money, you know, you get down A to Z. So you can imagine everything. There's some medical, there's some bridge, there's some that do SBA only. There's some that do working capital. There's a couple that do church. You know, they got a couple that do, you know, there's a working capital right there. You get some like church energy only. And then you can get into the secondary funding type. And that gives you, you know, if they do two types of lending or a third lending type. And then you got their programs and descriptions. So now you can come through here and you can go A to Z. By the 3.0, we'll also try to have it so we can, you can go in and scrape. You can just go in and pick a state. You can go, I want to pull up everybody that does residential hard money in Ohio. And you just basically pull up everybody that does Ohio. Because there's 40. Some lenders can lend in 46 states. And now I deal, guys, just be, you know, the two of you that aren't in the program, by the program like Doris is. I work with mostly more organized lenders. Not a lot of the man, you know, the local guy that a lot of people hear about. They're harder to find than I think, you know, that's a good situation if you can find somebody, you know, how they talk about go to your REI meeting or something like that. You meet some friend, somebody who can lend you money. That's a different story. I try to provide everything where people can have a database where, and those are guys like our hirer, and maybe they don't do it all the time. So a lot of them aren't going to advertise that they have a business when they have it, and they may only do it once or twice. And it may, so I'd like to find some people like that. It's just harder. This is easier to build a database. And like I said, we got hedge funds, we got family offices. Family offices don't advertise a lot of times. And it's, you know, you got all, you know, you got the family offices that got like $5 million all the way to Accession. And Accession is Jordan, this guy Jordan, and his, you know, he has one guy, one family, and I think their name is Musk. He basically is Elon Musk's family office. So obviously he is, you know, he doesn't do real estate. He does all the stuff that Elon does. You know, he's his right hand man. You don't really hear a lot about him, and you can Google him. And it comes up, but he's, you know, obviously he manages like, what, $200 billion or something like that. But yeah, this is our 1.0. So like I said, guys, what I'm going to be doing, you know, and you can, and like I said, you can go to 3.0, the 2 and the 3.0. This one is the lenderless 2. They're just set up a little different. Like I said, here in red, if it's in red, I'm putting it in no longer funding or something. These will be taken out by the 3.0. The 2.0 will be out sometime mid to end of June. And it will have, like I said, 8,000 more contacts, 7 databases. And then after that, end of summer into September or something, we'll have 12,000. It'll be 20,000. And then, like I said, and it'll be, at that point, we're going to constantly upgrade. So that is actually our databases. For those of you guys that have seen me before, and you guys have seen me post about the databases, keep in mind, we also have, I have 300 documents that are, you can download. Right now, there's about 60 of them in our real estate investor library. And I have like USB sticks, like 11 of them still that I got to like download. And I got 11 of these. So ready to have more documents. So if you need contracts, if you need agreements, purchase and sale agreements, if you need any kind of documents, I've got them for you and they're available to download. Our real estate investor library is kind of the intro to our associate program. And our real estate investor library, which includes the database, we just do that for $99. It's a one-time deal, and you get everything updated. When it gets updated, We put it in that group. You can just go download it. Our associate program's $399 one time fee. And like I said, we're starting June 7th, 16 weeks. And we're basically going to show everybody from A to Z. And Doris just went through those starting back in January. She's been there every week. We basically show everybody how to set up a business as a private money broker or as a private money lender. We also show you how they do underwriting. We have case studies, and we have a lot of data from underwriting from a lot of these different lenders that have dealt with. So we have a lot of that. We also recommend that you can use all these systems if you're just an investor or you want to borrow money or get investors. You can basically use the whole program. Plus, tonight in our associate program, it's kind of like the last one of this before we go to Memorial Day, and then we start again 16 weeks. We're doing analyzers. So tonight we've got Excel-based analyzers for short-term rentals for a couple for multifamily, all the way up to if you want to a really syndication where you need a lot of investors for a multi-million-dollar apartment complex acquisition, you can go through and do detail. Our short-term rental one has all the data for acquiring the property, everything you need for your lender or your investors, but you've also got furnishings. We actually go deep enough into furnishings, like what level of furniture is, and it talks about how you can make your furniture. Every one of our things has stress testing. So we provide, that's, so if you guys are interested in that, let me know, because like I said, we're June 5th and June 7th, we're starting 16 weeks. And the Monday nights will be, our existing group will be doing as a deal desk, because like I said, we have lenders in-house and people can have, and you're in the, if you join and do the Wednesdays, you can come over to Wednesday nights and you can present deals to our in-house people. And we got a lot of people in there that might lend you, that might do your deal for you. We got about 10 people. And so I'm setting that up to be like a deal desk, kind of like Shark Tank. You can come in there, present a deal and get it evaluated, get it critiqued and maybe get it funded. We are trying to go towards AI and automation. And I'm working on, just so Matt, you know, before you got here, we were talking about that through one of my associates who's in the roofing business. He did about 20,000 roofs, but he built a technology company to help construction people basically get takeoffs and measurements for, you know, imagine if, you know, if you're doing roofing work and you're working with insurance companies, you can go get the aerial measurements, and he can do gutters. He can do insulation in the house. He can do concrete, all these very accurate takeoff. He has about 30 employees. His office is in Republic Plaza in Denver. If you guys have seen the Denver skyline, it's the tallest building in Denver. And he just moved in there. When I worked for him, 6-7 years ago, he wasn't in that building. So his technology company is huge. And I want to basically work with him. And I talked to him today. I actually just ran into him today, this morning. And I'm going to meet with him next week after Memorial Day. We're going to try to incorporate all of our documents and all of our lender lists and use his, and I'm talking to him about incorporating all of his data. So not only do you get the access to like all the takeoffs, and you'll still have to probably buy them, but you'll get a better package. You'll get like a deal. You'll get a couple probably in the package for free for joining it. Plus getting the lender list, using AI, because he's using a lot of AI to incorporate an A to Z process. And Doris is the same when Justin was on, being able to also incorporate Privy. So I'm going to reach out to Benson at Privy, because imagine if you can get the scope stuff that we talked about that I just talked about, getting that with the lenders, the investors, getting that with our documents, getting that with AI. Honor.io, which is another program. I'm gonna put those links in again. If you can incorporate all that in an A to Z process that ends up with you in the same night, you log on at 5 o'clock, you basically secured a property. By the time you go to bed, you've got a property secured. You maybe have the LOIs out, you have the offers out through AI, and you basically are done. And you, how much more that'll give you your life back. Because, you know, you guys have heard the saying, you can always make more money. You can never make more time. Well, you can make a little bit more time if you save time in your processes. So I'm working on that system. That's kind of like the, what's everything that's going to lead to that we're doing right now, and being able to pull in the close to 100 people between all of our groups to basically build this program out. That's going to be phenomenal, and basically incorporate, because we're going to go and plug this data into those systems that he has, and be able to go out to all these investors and lenders and all that stuff, 20,000 of them. And all of a sudden, imagine you guys come out on Monday night and you got 200, 300 lenders and investors on there looking to do deals, and you get to present to them. That's kind of the direction we're going to go. So real quick. So Angela, just here, I'm going to ask a couple questions. So yes, they are vetted. We basically are going to be vetting them now through AI, basically plugging them in, because that's a little easy. We have vetted them. The only time we didn't, we kind of laxed off, like everybody can imagine, 2020. We hardly did anything during 2020 after about April to through most of the year. And the people like Kevin and Jesse, who are my business partners, Doris knows, and they helped teach our class. We didn't do anything in 2020. So we got a little lax. We did this program in 2020 and into 2021, but then we didn't do anything in 2022. And then we did this group in 2023. We're going to go through 2023. And by the end of it, we're going to launch basically this whole virtual system. So I'll give you guys kind of these links. So this is the company that I'm talking about, my friend's company. It's in Denver. I'm posting it right now. So you guys, and they have roofing. Like I said, you can go get roof scope. You can get plumbing. I mean, all kinds of different scopes. He's launching a program next week. He kind of vaguely talked about it to me when I was getting coffee. We run into each other all the time. And like, this guy's probably the best guy. He was in the roofing business and he was a younger guy. And he told them this morning he'd be a platinum contractor within 2 years. And they're like, yeah, everybody tells him that. Normally it takes about 4 to 5. He did it in 18 months. You have to do like 1,000 roofs. And he was, you know, he had his own call center. Like when I worked for him, I went to previous customers he had and they signed blank contracts in the driveway because they liked him so much, how his company ran. Like I just basically walked up and the guy's like, here, where do I sign? So he has Scope Technology. They're based in Denver. And like I said, I'm going to work with, so scopes are like aerial measurements, like satellite. So yeah, you can, and if you go, you can look at his website and they've got Rift Scope and they have some examples. So I don't know exactly what deal we're going to do. And I think what we're probably going to provide this to our associates that are, you know, in our 399 program, at least to build it with him, because he was, when I told him about this today, he's like, dude, you know me, I like to make money. And this is, I can incorporate this easily because we're already doing it. I mean, he doesn't really have to do very much. I want to take him, our lenders and our investors, and plug them in and see what we can do. And then obviously I don't control Privy. You guys have heard Privy. Privy is like, and there's PropWire and PropStream. PropWire has a free plus a paid, but you guys use Privy and you guys can contact Benson, who's the president of it, Benson Juarez. And Benson's also in Denver. I met him at the Pitbull conference, which I went to in 2019. Cost me $17,000 to be a sponsor there. And that's all private money. I mean, they're billion-dollar funds there. And it was the last one they did before COVID. They had to cancel the one in March that year because of COVID. And then they were able to do one in June because they went to Texas, which was like, Texas, you guys remember, was open. And they went to Austin and they basically, you know, they had to do a social distancing and all that. So Privy is a paid program. It's $97 a month, I believe, and it's $1,000 a year. You can do on-market, off-market properties. Benson has an upgrade where he also gives you a buyer list of known buyers. And on, you can get almost comps on there. He basically has access to MLS. So if you're looking for MLS data where everybody feels they can get it, he has it. He doesn't have them all because it's a time frame. You know, obviously they're paying the MLS providers for that. But he has MLS and he actually gets that actual data. And you guys can find Privy. You can watch Privy him work on YouTube. He has videos. So if you look up Privy and look up Benson, you can find him and you can watch along on what's already posted before you call him or reach out to him. So that's a good program. And like I said, another one that I just put up, and you know, there'll be people that complain. If I post this in like Jim Ingersoll's group, people will complain. It's like, you're not going to get accurate measurements. It still helps sometimes. HomeWise has three levels of, you know, if you go put in zip code, it can tell you like low, medium, high costs, you know, just some kind of estimate. I mean, these aren't going to be 100%. And I'm going to say that the caveat, it's not 100% accurate, but it may give you a ballpark and you can go into a lot of interior, exterior. You can do a lot of, I mean, I actually would do it sometimes if I had to get an estimate or something like that. We use a program called Xactimate when I was in the insurance, you know, restoration business, because most of the insurance companies use Xactimate. State Farm uses it and all that. So we always use the same, and you could actually probably get Xactimate. It's just, it's not really user-friendly for what we do, but you can actually, because you're going with insurance pricing, and you guys can imagine that insurance companies are not, they're not paying premium prices, you know, for a lot of things. But Xactimate was pretty good. And so we can use that. That was one good thing. And then when I was talking about Company Cam, and you guys can go on, Company Cam is a great resource. Like I said, they have the free version, the paid version. You will likely never need the paid version. The free is that good. I used it when I worked when I did work for Jared with this the scope and Metro Construction, he introduced me to it. I used it in my company. I use it now. You could use it as a, you know, you could use it just to keep your contractors and have them upload pictures of when on the draw schedule. So if you're doing that that group of list, you can have them complete all the pictures that are necessary for that group. You know, here's how he gets paid. Well, now here's how you get your draw from your lender. And if you get your lender on the same page, they may have a system. So I'm also, like I said, I'm introducing this to you on three levels. If you're a lender, if you're just brokering private money, actually, if you're a contractor, and if you're a real estate entrepreneur. So you got it. And you can use the free version. You get the paid version, whatever you want. So that's kind of just what I was going to go through tonight for everybody. I'm going to kind of do this every week because, like I said, probably, you know, 1,000 people should sign up for this just because I'm giving this all for free. I'm going to email you guys all these documents. You can use them however you want. If you just want to delete them, fine. I normally put these in my resource library. So you guys can imagine what you've seen, what I've given you tonight, just this group of information and documents. Imagine that I got when I got 11 more USB sticks, and I've already got 60-something documents uploaded, and we've got 20,000 contacts. So it's kind of just really the what I have tonight to offer you guys. If you guys have any questions, and then like I said, if you're interested in just the resource library, we can just download everything, and you get access to it on, you know, $99. And if you want to do the associate program with the private money program, it's $399, and it's like you're in for life. We start that June 7th. So that's a good program, and you can reach out to me, and I can, you know, it's great. Doris, you want to tell them a little bit about it, what you've experienced in it? Because Doris has been in it since January.
let's see. We have gone over some deals. We have the understanding. Some people, like he said, are gator related. They have worked with some gators. There's some of us that do land, multifamily, single family. We have some members who has a very interesting offer of helping you to get a 50 single family home portfolio, which can possibly, you can receive some funds at the end of the transaction. They will help you to find property manager to manage your property for you. Of course, you know, there's a fee involved with property manager that you have to take into consideration. We're a little bit crazy, but it's a friendly bunch. We all have the same goal of trying to help one another to be successful. And anything or any question that you may have, you can always reach out to Nate. He will respond back to you.
Yeah, we're gonna, and you know, Doris, the good thing is Dan is getting Bill's deal done.
So, great. Good.
Yeah, Dan, we have a friend, Matt Dan Munser, who comes from my partner, Jesse, and Jesse Page. And his Dan Munser is like, he doesn't advertise anywhere. He's one of Jesse's partners. Jesse's also a partner with me, myself and Kevin, my other partner. And Dan is getting some deals done. It's incredible. He has a lot of resources. He's in the process of buying a bank. So he's going through all the FDIC approval. I mean, literally the guy's got funds and he's got all kinds of ways to get deals done. And so Jesse's kind of his point of contact. My business partner is Kevin Knapp, and his cousins are the Stevensons in Denver. So they sold their dealerships. They sold all the real estate. They just sold their dealerships last year for $377 million and kept the land. So they're still leasing to the company that bought, and they had Chevrolet, Toyota, Lexus, Jaguars, all the name brands. They've been around since the 60s. My family's from Denver. I mean, I've known the Stevensons since I was born. I go drive right through there. They're in Golden. They're like the Golden Lakewood area, going up to from Denver towards the mountains. And they had Denver West Office Park, Denver West Village, Denver West Commons, and the land where the Cardinal Mills Mall is. Kevin's cousin, Greg, is like a one-man HOA in that whole area where all the dealerships were, the mall, everything. The mall got wrecked by hail. Denver West got wrecked by hail. Imagine, I'm in the roofing business, dude. I'm like, it all had wood-shake roofs. There's like 32 office buildings with wood-shake roofs. All got, you know, how many roofers were over there? But I didn't know Kevin at that time. If I'd known Kevin at that time, I probably would have made it. I probably would have had $1.5 million, $2 million insurance claim I would have got paid on. So that's my partner. And so a couple of them, we've been doing this for a while. We've actually been working on stuff since 2019. I started private money brokering in 2017, went full-time in 2018. Really just, you know, 2020, obviously, like everybody in my business kind of went, not, you know, but I do a lot of these programs to help, you know, I pretty much, we connect people with the money, you know, and give you all the tools and all the resources and where to reach out to people. And we have a realtor. I have a good, one of my good friends in Evergreen in my town is a realtor, big time. He does a lot of, the average home price in my town is $1 million. And we have like, we have one house right now, an estate in our town, $26 million is the listing right now. So it's a pretty affluent area, just west of Denver. So we got a lot of resources. So, and I'm also saying this for a lot of people because I'll actually post it in a couple of our different groups where we have people. So anybody wants to, you know, interested in talking further, like I said, these are all your free. You see me, I'm doing the free thing, sign up for it. Because I try to do these things and I give you guys these, you know, a lot of people don't give you anything for free, you know, and I do have the paid program, but the areas where people are hurting, I'm trying to give you guys my resources, scope of work and rehab, and a few of these resources. Nobody knows about Scope Technologies. We got there, a $20-25 million company that does all that. And they're willing, you know, Jared's like, it's a natural fit for what he does to expand into real estate. You know, so a lot of people will get a benefit from having that. And all these other resources, the company cam, HomeWise. So that's pretty much what I have tonight, unless you guys have any questions. And then you'll get your email tomorrow with all the documents. I have my associates program tonight with Doris and the other ones. And then I will post that video up in that group tomorrow. And then I will post this one and I'll send it. I mean, I'll basically send it to you guys with all the documents in the morning. So you'll get all those. You'll get more than what I just showed you. Because I have some that are redundant. I have four different versions of scope of work forms. So feel free if you want to delete them and don't use any of them, that's fine. If you want to use them or try them out, fine. I'll also be sending a CRM to you, like an Excel contact tracker. It basically will track up to 12 weeks of all your networking, your events. So if you're doing any kind of events, it'll track your offers, all your contacts. You put them in Excel, it's there, you know, you can search it. I'm going to be sending that out as well. And it's like, if you want to use it, cool. If not, no big deal. So other than that, guys, I'm ready to, I think we went 1 hour and 10 minutes. And so I've got our associate group in about 50 minutes, a little bit under an hour. So, yeah. So Matt, it was a great meeting, man.
Yeah, likewise. Hey, so I don't know really anything about lending other than I'm a commercial agent. And so I understand it from, you know, as an investor.
Yeah.
Commercial estate. So I've not done anything with lending or brokering or anything from that aspect.
Yeah. I mean, our program would be good if you want to learn that. Cause I mean, like I said, I try to price it because there's a lot of people. I have a friend who's a retired Marine, is $50,000 in the education. And he didn't have any money left to do a dump, you know, two companies. And it's like, they kept like, you want this? That's an upgrade. You want this? That's an upgrade. You know, they kept doing the upsell. And so I basically, you know, everybody kept like, hey, you should start like more money. Some of the Gators, like the Gators, $1,800 to sign up for the Gator program. It's $11,000 for their platinum version or whatever. And I'm like, I had somebody tell me they were going to sign up for that. They signed up for mine. I said, because I front load everything. I basically give everybody the invitation to our group, our private group. And it's everything's in the files tab. So you can just go and download it. And whatever you need. And if you don't need it or like it, you can delete it. If you like it and use it, boom. Everything you can do, find and replace, copy and paste, put your own logos, put your name. They've all been lawyered up. They're all good. You can brand them whatever you want. But our program basically runs everybody starting from zero, whether you're a lender, you're a private money broker, or you're an entrepreneur just borrowing money and trying to get investors. You start at like getting like the client engagement fee. You start at like doing the checklist of the requirements of what lenders, and we go off the strictest lenders that I know. So that way, if you can comply with the strictest and you build your files around that, your everyday files, we talk about this on our program with our people, your everyday files are going to be your bank statements and the things that you're going to have for everybody. And you build that up. So, you know, every 3 months, you got to update your bank statements, things like that. That way you have your own folder. Then what do they require? Do they require you to have insurance and hazard, you know, all that on the property? Then you've got all those other requirements that they have, plus obviously the purchase and sale agreements. They're going to want to see, these are more organized lenders. These aren't, like I said, the man, you know, the guy in Times Square that has the trench coat and the watches and hard money loans. And they're great guys out there, but they're hard. Everybody's like, oh, those are the guys you need to talk to. Well, I have 20,000 contacts. It's like, you're going to be able to find a lender. And if you've got a client or somebody, you can get paid. Most of the lenders, I'm working with, helping Doris and everybody sign up for five. There's not a lot. There's maybe about 50 lenders that have broker programs, Vizio and all that, Vizio, Kogo, Lending One, Lima One. You'd be awesome at, you know, in that. And you can sign up for free with them. I have all their broker agreements and their rental programs, Rentals 360 for rentals and VRBO and Airbnb short-term rental deals, all that. They pay 1 to 5 points at closing. So it's lucrative. I tell people you can do that. You could work with our lenders, our in-house lenders are going to come on because you could actually, you know, people can actually do two tracks if they're just trying to make money and, you know, while they're getting the saving up to get their down payment together for their first property, they can get a couple of tracks and get expense. And I'd make this like, you know, $399 is pretty, everybody keeps telling me you need to charge like more. And I'm like, eventually I'm going to, when I get all this program with the AI and I get scope tech and all that stuff together, yeah, and we get that whole package together. And what we've talked about, what we told everybody that's in right now, everybody that's in is grandfather. It's going to be, they're going to be getting it for the, just being in the beta. You know, that's the goal. And then basically everybody that's new at some point will be the ones who actually pay money, like real money for it. So that way it's, because there's a lot of stuff we can incorporate with AI right now. Yeah, we talked a little bit about that in our class. We have a member, one of our associates, who was really guru in AI, and he did a 2-hour thing where he got three properties in like 2 hours, just showing everybody how he went through the process. And he used Hunter.io, which is they have a free and a paid. He has ChatGPT. Now ChatGPT-4 has the app. You can get the Apple and you can get it on Android, and you can actually use your phone for it or your laptop, the paid version. And it's like, I think it's like $7 a week or something like that. You can get that. And so he basically showed people how to use it from A to Z using Hunter.io, which is like your emails, how to use the ChatGPT. We'll write your letters or write your LOI for you. And then you basically import that, how you can use True People Search, and you can actually go and just, it's like, you know, it's just like a database. You can find people and their addresses and stuff, and it's free, 100% free. And then you can go, and then he showed people how you can go to the county clerks, and literally in 2 hours, he had three offers in. And then he, you know, the only thing is we're still not able to incorporate lenders and investors because we need to bring them in to it. You know, at that point, we're going to be able to have a program where you get home from, somebody gets home from their 9-to-5 job, and after they make dinner or whatever, have dinner, and then 6 o'clock rolls around while their kids are doing homework, fire up the laptop and secure a property with A to Z, and it's all automated. And that's kind of what we're looking at. We're going to be able to do it. We have all the components. It's just now combining it. So, but yeah, mm-hmm. So it's pretty cool.
Yeah. I'd be interested in learning more. I honestly saw something about this with some lending stuff. I really didn't have any idea what I was hopping on. So, but the lending question has come up several times.
So. Yeah. I mean, everything's good, and we got more stuff that, we got a lot of stuff that even is outside of lending stuff, because I just make sure that everybody has, you know, because a lot of people I went to 23 real estate seminars before I went to the one with Lee Arnold, and they said private money broker. I'd never heard about that. And I'm like, because everyone that I walked out of or I left at the end of it, I was disappointed because they were like $2,500, and I'd see 40 people go to the back of the room and fuck off over $2,500. And, you know, Fortune Builders and all those companies and Renatus, and I think, Nudge got taken down by the FTC. They're a $400 million company. I don't see a lot of them give value to people. And so when I went to that program, I spent $1,500, and I spent 4 days in a class, and I got certified, and I did 250 deals in about 3 years, just as a private money broker. And I made really good money. And then I just started running into the same thing where I just see people getting, it's a jungle out there. People don't know what they're, you know, it's hard. So I put a couple groups together to kind of do this and kind of facilitate. And I didn't want to, because people are getting cut up for money all the time. I have to make a little bit worth my time. And I reinvest some of the money, you know, pay VAs and stuff. And now.
Yeah. And so, like, you're not actually being the lender when you're brokering this. You're brokering it from the lenders that you've got access to.
Yeah, there's two ways you can do that. You can actually broker it, and they're paying you at the closing. The title company is actually closing. You do sign up for Kogo Vizio. You have the HUD one, obviously you have your broker fee and all that stuff, and it tells the title company to it gives you direction to pay. So basically you get your commission. It can be 1 to 5 points. Most of them are going to be 2 or 3 points. When you first start with COBRA, they start with one until you've had 5 deals, and you give it 2. Then after 10 deals, they pay you 3 points on everything. You can
do that's with no actual lending license though, right?
Yeah, they can do it. They can lend in 43 states.
Right.
And another state can do, and they even have a map. They have 2 maps. One is all the states they can do, and then they have the judicial versus non-judicial. So it tells you non-judicial, you know, you don't need a judge to do the foreclosure or whatever process is. It's a lot different of a world, and you probably know that from your real estate broker. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. If you're lending, if you could actually still lend, and it's not your money. Rock Capital ROC has a program called white label table funding, just like a lot of mortgage brokers have. With nobody knows where the money is actually coming. It's not their money. They're loaning somebody else's money as a lender. So it's just like having a correspondence account, like with JP Morgan. You know, you got $30 million of their money, and as long as they're making money, they have parameters and agreements with you, you can lend their money, and the money goes to the escrow company from them, but your client, your borrower, thinks it's yours and you're a lender. So you can actually do that with, it's a pretty good process. And then you can use all the forms, because we have applications, we have credit applications. I mean, you have all that stuff in our files tab area. You can download and make it your own for your own lending business, and you could be white label. You know, you could set up whatever, you could broker to start with, and then get 25 or 30 deals, and then all of a sudden go to Rock and some of the other companies, and you have your own lending company, and you basically come. And I've got a couple of people doing that right now. We basically are like trying to mentor. It's not a mentor. I don't call myself a mentor, coach, or guru. I'm a facilitator. I'm a provider. I basically work with myself as a resource library. I built up a ton of resources brokering. I always try to help. I did a $7 million deal, and I basically found a family office, and that was without having my family office list that I have now. And I brokered the deal, and I made like $200,000 commission, which I put back in the company. And I was like, I should have held back, because that was just like 3 months before COVID. I was like, I could have used like $50,000 from that, during COVID. But, so we have all the resources to do that. And then, like I said, all of our people are, we've got people that are just brand new to. We got a guy that's done $30 million a deal. Dan Munser he's joined. He's got multiple. I mean, literally that guy put together a deal with Bill Johnson, who's also a lender. He's in Grand Junction, Colorado. Bill's doing a 3,000 acre development in Texas, and Dan's getting it funded. So he's got resources. I get the enjoyment now organically of like, we start tonight, like at 6 o'clock. We'll start, and by 7:30, I'll probably have 2 or 3 people that have done deals in the last week with each other. And I'm not even involved at those deals. They're just happening. Mm-hmm. They're happening without me, which is what I want, because I'm at the point now where I want to focus on transitioning into this virtual, into this other system with the AI and the automation. That's the way it's going to go. And that way, then people can come in at $3,500, whatever it is. And people should be lining up for that, because it's like a totally automated system that you're basically eliminating your wholesaler, you're eliminating the skip tracer, you're eliminating the list providers. You're getting it all automated, doing it. You're all automated, and you're almost able to. Obviously, there's some areas you probably won't be able to get into. Multifamily is a lot more with syndications and all that. It's a little bit more involved. And I have connections with a few securities attorneys, so we can make referrals to securities attorneys. And they do flat rates if people want to raise capital. I'm very well, I can talk a lot about SEC and Regulation D. I've had securities attorneys ask me if I went to law school and just didn't take the bar. So, because I study a lot, and I'm just constantly into things like that. So I can give you kind of the nutshell layperson version of like Regulation D and how to do things and what you can do and different things in different states to raise money with the SEC. And all that stuff. And then if somebody wants to go raise money, then I'm just going to give you like 5. Because like I did tonight, I'm going to say, here's 5 contacts. Just go talk to these securities attorneys, and you can choose which one you want to use. And they charge anywhere from 8 to whatever you want. If you're going to do something more complicated, but most of them have a flat rate. But yeah, that's pretty much a nutshell. Like I said, our program is really good, and we start 16 weeks fresh. So we do start like 0 week. And it's just kind of like 0 week is introduction, and we basically start from the get-go. And we do a lot of, you know, I do in my session, like I did tonight, I kind of come back. People come in late, so I'll come back and spend like 2 or 3 minutes. And then, you know, people need help. A lot of people hit me up. We did a special session a couple of weeks ago on the 1.0 because people are like trying to navigate it. It's a pivot table. It's not exactly perfect the way I want it, but at the time, it's awesome. I mean, it's everything's there. So you've got the data. I mean, some of it you still got to kind of play with to pull it out, but it's there. That's the hard part. The hard part is collecting the data and getting all the stuff. The easy part, you know, is basically searching for it and then just a little bit of work finagling to pull the data out that you actually need, but it's there. So it's like I said, it's like going to the library. You still have to go find go to the drawer and pull out the cards or now go to the computers and you still got to find where the aisle is or whatever. You know, it's there in the library. It's just, you still got to go in there and know how to use that resource. But no, I try to build this resource and we have a lot of stuff in there that's, like I said, I've got scope of work and I've got the construction a background at least to show people how to use these. Nobody's heard of scope tech, you know, in the real estate investing community. So it could be something that could help a lot of people just have a little bit more of an advantage over the competitors. And then, you know, obviously home-wise, like I said, it's not perfect, but hey, you can get numbers. You can start at least working numbers. And in your zip code, you can go in and plug your zip code in and some other resources. And I tell people, you know, set up your own separate LLC. And that way, we also do get an LLC. We talked about Wyoming and South Dakota and different states besides Delaware and Nevada. We've got contacts in Wyoming. I'm in Colorado, so I have a lot of my LLCs in Wyoming. But I, you know, now it's great. You know, no income taxes, no corporate taxes and all that. I can be there in 2 hours. I can be in Cheyenne in 2 hours. So I can, we talk a lot about that stuff. So a lot of times, and you see me in groups, you've seen me before. And some people are like, oh, you're not an attorney. How do you know this? It's like, I've just been doing, you know, because enough of my clients have done this stuff and I've been involved with these deals going down. You know, I've been involved with a lot of deals where securities attorneys were involved. So I've kind of seen them structure deals and how they do the SEC stuff. You know, so a lot of good stuff. Like I said, I'll send you all the resources in the morning, the email. And if you're interested, if you want to talk more, that, you know, we can definitely talk about if you want to do that, you know, join us or whatever. We got a few more. Like I said, we're going to make it, I think this is going to be the last group we're going to do it this way before we go automated.
Okay. Well, yeah, look forward to it. So I'll circle back to you and we'll talk a little more.
Yeah, cool. No problem. I'm going to get some water and feed before 6 o'clock.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, Matt.
Have a good night. Appreciate it.
Yeah, dude. Yeah, no problem. Reach back out to me when you got a question or, you know, friend me on Facebook, you know, if you haven't already.
Of course.
Okay, dude. All right.
Appreciate it. Thanks.
Okay, Doris, I'll see you in about a half an hour.